Welcome to today's edition of Crypto Corner at InvestorIdeas.com. News on what's driving the cryptocurrency market. Hey everyone, this is Sam Mowers here, and welcome to episode 433 of the Crypto Corner podcast. For news today, Bitcoin has weathered a flash crash and maintained its $11,000 support level. Galaxy Digital is seeing near-record trading levels, and the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange is launching a blockchain securities platform. But just before we dive into today's show, a quick reminder that if you enjoy this podcast, please feel free to share or leave us a review. I also recommend checking out some of the other podcasts on InvestorIdeas.com. This includes the Cannabis Podcast, as well as the Clean Tech and Climate Change Podcast, both of which will bring you up to speed on the latest stock news and trends in their respective spaces. So Bitcoin weathered the past weekend to enter August's first week with its $11,000 support level intact. At the time of recording, it is trading for about $11,200, according to data from CoinMarketCap. Over the weekend, Bitcoin first climbed to around $11,969, just missing $12,000 on Sunday, only to experience a flash crash of $1,458 in 10 minutes, pulling it down to $10,659, according to data from CoinDesk. That publication goes on to indicate that this crash led to the liquidation of nearly $1.4 billion worth of positions across major exchanges, $144 million worth of sell liquidations or forced closure of long positions on BitMEX, the highest seen since May 10th, and more as buying pressure was reduced in the market. As we have seen, however, this doesn't as of yet seem to have spoiled investors' confidence in the cryptocurrency. Max Keiser, for instance, that's the founder of Heisenberg Capital and host of Markets and Finance show The Keiser Report, tweeted, admittedly before Sunday's brief crash, quote, "The $20,000 level for Bitcoin won't pose any resistance. We won't see any resistance till $28,000. A brief pullback, then the assault on $100,000 begins with renewed vigor," end quote. Moving on, The Block reports that Galaxy Digital Holdings Limited, which trades on the TSX under the ticker symbol GLXY, is experiencing near-record levels of trading volume amid Bitcoin's current rally. Tim Plakas, the sales lead for Galaxy Digital Trading, told the publication via email, quote, "We've seen a strong increase in volumes through our desk since the start of the year as our institutional counterparty base has grown in size and sophistication. In terms of the recent move higher, the uptick in volumes we've seen will put this month on track to be at record levels in line with what we saw during the climb out of crypto winter back in the spring of 2019. End quote. A recent announcement from the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange revealed plans for the launch of a central system for securities lending based on blockchain technology. Orly Greenfeld, the senior vice president and director of the exchange's clearing department, explained, quote, "The Tel Aviv Stock Exchange is proud to launch the first loan database system of its kind as a secure, innovative, and groundbreaking platform. Blockchain technology will enable securities lending trading while securing information and supporting the increase in the number of transactions. The stock exchange is a world leader in the field of financial technological innovation and continues to work for the development of the capital market as part of its strategic plan." End quote. That does it for today's Crypto Corner. If you would like to be a guest or sponsor for this podcast, contact InvestorIdeas.com. Investor Ideas reminds all listeners to read our disclaimers and disclosures on the InvestorIdeas.com website, and this podcast is not an endorsement to buy products, services, or securities. Investors are reminded all investment involves risk and possible loss of investment. To hear more InvestorIdeas.com podcasts, please visit InvestorIdeas.com/audio. And a reminder, you can also hear our podcasts on Spotify, iTunes, TuneIn, Stitcher, Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio.com, and Google Play Music.